Good evening, everyone. Welcome to St. Patrick Basilica for our celebration of Holy Thursday of the Lord's Supper. The prayers and readings for today can be found in a Sunday Missal, beginning at page 283. We have one announcement. After this Mass, the Basilica will remain open for adoration until night prayer at 9:30, after which the Basilica closes. Please be advised that this Mass is being live-streamed, and we welcome all those who are joining us. Please stand and join left high the cross number 606.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, We have completed our Lenten observance and now have begun the solemn celebration of the Easter feast. On these great days, it is our duty to glory in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, in whom we have our salvation, life, and resurrection. These oils that we receive tonight were blessed and consecrated at the Chrism Mass on Tuesday by Archbishop Damphous, our bishop, for use throughout the year. These oils will be used when the sick are anointed, when those awaiting the waters of rebirth are strengthened, and when those who are baptized and confirmed share in the mission of Christ, the Anointed One. By the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, who fills these holy oils with life and grace, the saving work of Jesus Christ is continued in the church. The oil of the sick. This oil of the sick has been blessed by our bishop for the healing of the body, mind, and soul. May the sick who are anointed with it experience the compassion of Christ and his saving love. The oil of catechumens has been blessed by our bishop for the anointing of those preparing for baptism. Through this anointing, they are strengthened by Christ to resist the power of Satan and reject evil in all of its forms as they prepare for the saving waters of baptism. The oil of catechumens. The Holy Chrism, a mixture of olive oil and perfume, has been consecrated by our bishop and the priests of our archdiocese. It will be used to anoint infants after baptism, those who are to be confirmed, bishops and priests at their ordination, and altars and churches at the time of their dedication. The chrism oil. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son went about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall mark for you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell the whole congregation of Israel that on the 10th of this month, they are to take a lamb for each family, a lamb for each household. If a household is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join its closest neighbor in obtaining one. The lamb shall be divided in proportion to the number of people who eat of it. Your lamb shall be without blemish, a year-old male. You may take it from the sheep or from the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. Then the whole assembled congregation of Israel shall slaughter it at twilight. They shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorposts and on the lintel of the houses in which they eat it. They shall eat the lamb that same night. They shall eat it roasted over the fire with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you should eat it: your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand, and you shall eat it hurriedly. It is the Passover of the Lord. For I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will strike down every firstborn in the land of Egypt, both human beings and animals. On all the gods of Egypt, I will execute judgments. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you live. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague shall destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. This day shall be a day of remembrance for you. You shall celebrate it as a festival to the Lord throughout your generations. You shall observe it as a perpetual ordinance." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The cup of blessing that we bless is a sharing in the blood of Christ. The cup of blessing that we bless is sharing in the blood of Christ. What shall I return to the Lord for all his bounty to me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. The cup of blessing that we bless is a sharing in the blood of Christ. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. I am your servant, the son of your serving girl. You have loosed my bonds. The cup of blessing that we bless is a sharing in the blood of Christ. I will offer to you a thanksgiving sacrifice and call on the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. The cup of blessing that we bless is a sharing in the blood of Christ.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. I give you a new commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put it into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head. Jesus said to him, one who has bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you. For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason, he said, not all of you are clean. After he had washed their feet, put on his robe, and returned to the table, Jesus said to them, do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example, that you also should do as I have done to you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
It may seem for some of us rather strange that on this night, when we gather to celebrate the institution of the great gift of the Eucharist, a night where we will, after receiving the body of Christ, take the Blessed Sacrament in procession to a side altar, where we will be invited to stay and pray, that we just read a gospel where there is no mention of bread nor wine, no words where Jesus says, take, eat, drink, body or blood. Instead, we read of water, of a towel and a basin, of an act so unusual that the head of the apostles questions it and first refuses it. We would think, wouldn't we, that the words, do this in memory of me, should be the ones that the deacon would proclaim as he reads from the Holy Gospel on this night. Words repeated, it is estimated some 350,000 times each day around the world, at least 22 times each week here in this basilica. Words repeated for 2,000 years in every continent, in magnificent cathedrals, cloistered convents, in school gymnasiums, nursing homes, and prisons. In cities and towns, in provinces and states, countries and continents. And yet, what we have heard proclaimed not only here, but in every Catholic church around the world this night, is a story of an act of service, one usually reserved for the lowest of all the slaves. These are the words that have echoed from this pulpit, that you also should do as I have done to you. Let us consider for a moment how strange this scene really is. God in the flesh, Savior of the world, the resurrection and the life, is kneeling on the floor, washing the feet of his friend. One by one dirty foot after another, Jesus works his way across the room as he washes the feet of the man who is going to betray him. The feet of the man who is going to deny that he even knew him. The feet of the man he selected to lead this new church, yet who will use those feet to run as fast and as far away as possible in just a matter of hours.
The feet of the 12 who will use part of this evening arguing over which one of them is the best. The feet of those who will fall asleep when he asks them to stay awake. And after all that they had seen and heard over 3 years, are still unsure of who Jesus is and what he came to do. And yet, he bends down, pours water, takes a basin, cleans feet, and dries them with a towel. Jesus not only has given us the most precious gift of his body and blood, he has given us a gift of his example, and has asked us to do what he has done. As we begin these 4 days of this Easter Triduum, there is so much for us to consider as we gather at table, move to a garden, pray with Jesus, stand at the foot of a cross, and then move toward a tomb that will not be in use for very long. Through it all, through the events of the Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, we have this question before us tonight, one we might well play with, pray with, and contemplate over the next few hours. Do you know what I have done to you? Bread, wine, body, blood, water, towel, betrayal, arrest, trial, crown of thorns, wood of the cross, nails, agony, death, burial, resurrection. Do you know what I have done to you? Do we know?
will see our friends whose feet were washed tonight at the Easter Vigil, where they will be received into full communion with the Roman Catholic Church. Please stand. Brothers and sisters, as we gather in this Eucharist to commemorate our liberation from slavery to sin and death, let us pray that all believers will pass over from death to life with Christ as we intercede for the needs of our church and our world.
We pray that our Lord in the most holy Eucharist will nourish all Christians so that all the baptized become united more closely to the church, the body of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord who humbled himself to wash his apostles' feet will give to all who serve him the gift of patient self-sacrifice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Holy Spirit increase the faith of those receiving sacraments of initiation, this Triduum, and grant them the understanding that leads to perseverance. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We remember the sick and infirm, as well as those who care for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the faithful departed, especially those of our parish, that they may share the company of the saints in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Hear our prayers, O loving God, as we celebrate the self-sacrificing love of your Son in the gift of the Eucharist. Renew your presence among us, that our faith will be stronger, our hope more secure, and our charity ever more generous. Through Christ our Lord.
fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial, as we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Thank you.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, Marcel, our Bishop, and Ivan, his auxiliary, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, we, your servants, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and in paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysanagus, John and Paul, Cosmos and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace, and command that we may be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. The day before he was to suffer, for our salvation and the salvation of all, that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation.
Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as ones you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel, the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim.
In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that your gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who though sinners hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints, admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of our God.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be saved.
For the distribution of communion, use the center aisle or the aisles by the windows to come to communion, and return by the aisles with the pillars. Consume the host immediately before leaving the front area. Thank you.
Thank you.
betray.
A deacon asked me to serve the precious one.
There is no precious blood. Yeah,
there's one.
It should be a priest tonight.
Okay,
yes.
So I'll see.
Yeah, thanks.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Please kneel.